Here we're going to introduce what's called the definition of a function and the vertical line test. So we're going to imagine a scenario. We're going to throw a ball into the air, and t is going to represent time measured in seconds, and h is going to represent height measured in feet. So I have two tables here, and the question I want to ask you is, which possible table could possibly really describe the ball? Which one of these is realistic? Okay. So remember, t is time and h is height. So this says that when the time is 0, the height is 3. When the time is 1, the height is 5. Time is 2, height is 7. Time is 3, height is 10. Time is 6 seconds, height is 7. Now you might say, wait a minute, the ball's at the same height at different times. And that's okay, right? Because if you throw a ball up and it's at 7 feet, on the way back down, it might be at 7 feet again. So this seems okay. In other words, the heights can repeat. But over here, let's look at this table. The time is 0, the height is 3. Time is 1, the height is 6. Time is 2, the height is 7. Time is 2, the height is 8. What? That's not possible. The ball can't be both at 7 feet and at 8 feet when the time is 2 seconds. So this is a problem, right? So here the problem is that you have the same time, but different heights for the ball. So what? Okay, and so that's impossible. So impossible. So this table cannot possibly describe the motion of the ball because it's impossible. We can't, at 2 seconds, the ball can't be both at 7 feet and at 8 feet. So this would be the table that we would believe if somebody gave us data. Now, we're gonna go ahead and use these tables to motivate the definition of a function. So we're going to label this column right here, these numbers, that is all the times. We're going to call these inputs. So inputs. Okay, and we're going to call these the outputs. So likewise over here, these will be the inputs and these will be the outputs. Now we know this table doesn't represent the realistic situation for a ball, but we're still going to compare it to this table. So what we're now going to do is we're going to create ordered pairs. Where the x coordinate or the first number is the time, and the second number is the height. Okay, so the first ordered pair would be 0, 3. And the second one will be 1, 5. And the third one's going to be, for this table, it's going to be 2, 7. And the third ordered pair is going to be 3, 10. And then finally, it's going to be 6, 7. Okay? Now, I'm going to put these 5 ordered pairs in braces. And these little braces right here is going to tell me that this is a collection. Okay? When we use this symbol in math, the braces, this denotes what are called sets. And a set is simply a collection. Like you might collect records or something. And in your set, in your collection, you have records. And the commas separate the members of your set. So here's the first member of my set, here's the second, third member, fourth member, and fifth member, okay? So this is a set of ordered pairs. Likewise, let's create a set of ordered pairs for the second table, okay? And that set would look like this. So let's do that over here. First one's gonna be 0, 3, then it's gonna be 1, 6, and the third ordered pair is going to be 2, 7, and then 2, 8, and then 3, 12. And then finally, the last ordered pair is going to be 6, 3. Okay, and I'm going to use a brace again. So again, here's the first collection of ordered pairs. Here's the second collection of ordered pairs. Okay, so looking at these sets, and using this notation, we're ready for the definition of a function. So here's our definition of a function. It's a set of ordered pairs where inputs occur only once. Okay? And that's it. That's the definition of a function. It's simply a set of ordered pairs where inputs occur only once. And so when I look over here, remember these are my inputs, right? And if I look at the ordered pair, okay, well, a set of ordered pairs. Now a set, remember, is denoted with these little braces, and each of these are ordered pairs. And so when I look at these five ordered pairs, I look at the inputs, 0, 1, 2, 3, 6. Every input occurred only once, right? Look at the second set of ordered pairs. 0, 1, 2, 2, 3, 6. So do you see the two occurring twice? Once right there and once right there? That's why this set right here, the set of ordered pairs, is not a function. Because it wasn't the case that the inputs occurred only once. But this one was a function, right? So this set is a function. Because the input, every input occurred only one time. Okay, so there are lots of scenarios where this is important, where we only want the inputs to occur once. And all you have to do is look at the ordered pairs to assess whether or not you have a function on your hands. Okay, now it turns out there's another way to visually represent the function, or a set that is a function. Let's go ahead and see an example of that now. Okay, so here's our scenario. We're going to graph A and B. Well, what are A and B? A and B are collections, right? Here's A, and then here's B. And this was a mistake. Okay, so A is the first collection, right? Now, notice it's a set of ordered pairs. Here's the first ordered pair. Here's the second, third, and fourth. And B has four ordered pairs as well, right? First ordered pair, second ordered pair, third, and fourth. So the first thing this problem asks us to do is to graph A and B on separate sets of axes. So this will be for A, and this will be for B. B, okay? And then the question is this, which is a function? Now, I can already tell, I really don't have to graph and tell which is a function, right? Can you tell which is a function? Well, remember the definition. The inputs can only occur once. Not the outputs. We don't care about the output. We just care about the input, the first coordinate. Let's see. Let's look at A. Negative 1, 1, 3, and 3. Oh, whoops. A is not a function because the input repeats. Let's look at B. Inputs, negative 2, 0, 2, 3. Okay, I can see B is going to be a function and A is not going to be a function. But let's go ahead and do what the problem asks us to do and graph A and B. Let's first graph A. So let's see, negative 1, 3, negative 1, 3 up here. Okay, and the second one is 1, 4 way up here. And then we've got 3, negative 2, 3, negative 2, like maybe there. And let's see, then 3, 5. So 3, 5 is way up here. Okay, that's the graph of A. And the graph of B is just four ordered pairs as well. So let's see, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 4, 2, 4, and then 3, 1. Okay, and we said earlier, we mentioned, right, that, well, you can't have the inputs repeating to be a function. And we said, oh, look, this is a problem, right? 3, negative 2, 3, 5. And those are the points right here. Here's 3, negative 2, and here's 3, 5. Okay, now, because these two points have the same input, we said this is not a function. Okay, but B over here, right? We said it was a function because the inputs don't repeat. So this was a function. Now, let me ask you this. If you just looked at the graphs of A and B, is there a way to visually tell that A is not a function and B is? Well, notice this. These two points have the same input, right? That's why A is not a function. And if I drew a vertical line, like so, a dotted vertical line, do you see how these two points are on the same vertical line? That happens because they both have the same x-coordinate, right? So the idea is this, if you can draw a vertical line and you have two points on that vertical line, then it's not a function, right? That's our little graphing test. And look over here, the same test works. Look, any vertical line I draw, anywhere I draw a vertical line, right? I don't have two points on the vertical line. I only have a maximum of one. So what we just established, or what we just talked about, is called the vertical line test, which is very important. Let's write that down. This is called the vertical line test. Okay, and it says this. A set of ordered pairs passes the vertical line test. And so is a function. And so is a function. Okay, if any vertical line intersects the graph at most once. Okay? And this is called the vertical line test. Let's read that again. A set of ordered pairs passes the vertical line test. Okay? And so is a function. In other words, the vertical line test will tell you whether or not you have a function on your hands. If what's true? Any vertical line, okay, any vertical line you draw intersects the graph at most once. Okay, if a vertical line intersects more than once, it's not a function. So A fails the vertical line test. Fails the vertical line test. VLT, vertical line test. And likewise, B passes. Hooray! The vertical line test. Okay, and that's why it's a function. Okay, let's go ahead and here, you know, these functions only have had four ordered pairs. What if I gave you a set where there were infinite ordered pairs? Whoa, how are you going to figure out whether or not you have a function on your hands? Good question. Let's go ahead and take an example like that. Okay, so here's my question. Which is a function? Now, these curves have infinite ordered pairs, right? So I can't list them all, right? But what I can do is say, hey, which one passes the vertical line test? So we start drawing vertical lines. Do you see how any vertical line I draw will cross or intersect this graph at most once? So this passes, this first graph right here passes the vertical line test. And so yes, it's a function. Okay, so it's yes for the first one. How about this one, this graph? Well, if I draw a vertical line, let's say I draw a vertical line like this. Well, that vertical line intersects the graph only once. But this vertical line, for example, intersects how many times? Well, once, twice, three times. And what we said is that any vertical line can intersect at most once. So this graph is not a function. It fails the vertical line test. So this fails the vertical line test. And so we conclude it's no, not a function, unfortunately. Okay, and then how about this one, this third graph? Well, does it pass or fail the vertical line test? Clearly it fails the vertical line test. If I draw a vertical line here, I can see it intersects there and there. So this would be no, fails the vertical line test. How about this graph? Any vertical line, right? Yep, any vertical line you draw intersects only at most one time. So the answer is yes. Okay, so what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be looking at ordered pairs in different ways both graphically and written out using equations, and we're going to ask ourselves, do we have a function on our hands? We often use the vertical line test when we're talking about graphing, and once you have functions, there's lots we can do with them in mathematics, and we'll continue the journey of functions throughout this course. Until next time.